Hello friends, welcome to my channel. So in this video we will take questions from resonance effect. We all know what is resonance effect, but we will say take some tricky questions and how to solve them. So it is second part of concept builder, and suppose I want to compare stability of these two ions. This is the one and this one is second. Then you have to find out which one is more stable. So how you can find out? There are some rules to find out the stability of resonance structures. So first rule is, and second example is, suppose I have this one. So you have to decide which is more stable. So there are some rules. First rule is, if you have charged and uncharged species, then uncharged species are more stable. Okay, so uncharged are more stable. Now we will talk about the charged species. Charged means some positive or negative charge. So in charged species you have to remember certain things, and on the basis of the sequence of rules you have to decide stability of compounds. Okay, so first thing is number of covalent bonds. So with the increase in number of covalent bonds, stability increases. This is very important thing. Okay, and on the basis of this rule you can decide stability of these two. In this one and this one, there is one more covalent bond. Okay, so this one is more stable, you can decide. So first thing you have to check, number of covalent bonds. If number of covalent bonds are greater in any of the species, then stability will be higher for that. And if the number of covalent bonds are same, then you have to check charge separation. Charge separation is low. When the charge separation is low, stability is high. The second thing to check is charge separation. Suppose charge separation is also same. Okay, in that these two cases, charge separation, number of covalent bonds are equal. 3, 1, 4, 2 plus 2, 4. Charge separation is also equal between two adjacent atoms. Okay, so this rule cannot be applied here. Then third important thing is, next thing you have to check is like charges should be at maximum distance. There should be maximum distance between like charges. Then next thing you have to check is, negative charge should be on more electronegative atom. Means a atom which having more electronegativity will pull electrons toward it, and it will be more stable in that case. So in these two species, negative charge, in this case it is present on carbon, and in this case it is present on nitrogen. And you can easily compare that electronegativity is higher for nitrogen. So negative charge present on nitrogen in this species, therefore it is more stable. So on the basis of these things you can easily find out stability of resonance structure, but you should have to check in this particular sequence. There can be exceptions, but most of the time these four rules can help you easily. Then in case of uncharged and charged species, I have said that uncharged species are more stable than charged, but there is also an exception. Suppose you have a structure which is anti-aromatic in the starting. Suppose this one. This is anti-aromatic. It is following 4N rule. Now if I have placed one negative charge over here, then this will become aromatic system. And in that situation, it will be more stable. Okay. So exceptions can be there, but you have to check certain things, certain factors, that aromaticity will provide more stability. But most of the time, this rule follows. The next thing is, you know what is plus R and minus R effect. Okay, so plus R effect, when a lone pair of electron will be donated by a system. Okay, so you can easily find out which systems are plus, which system will show plus R effect, like OH, OR, NH2. When we have lone pair of electron present on this atom, connecting atom, then it will be plus R effect causing that this one This is also plus R effect. Minus R effect means when we are pulling electron from the system, a group which can pull electron from the system. Like we have CN. So CN will pull electron. Suppose it is connected with a system like CH3, CH and I have this one. So it will, this nitrogen has higher electronegativity, so it will try to pull electron towards it. Like this. So it is an example of minus R effect. Okay. Similarly, you can have nitro group. So this is nitro group. So this oxygen will pull electron towards it. So system, this whole group is pulling electron from the system. So it is minus R effect. Certain groups are there which can show plus R as well as minus R effect, like NO. Then you have alkenes. They can also show plus and minus R effect. And pH, phenyl ring, can also show plus R and minus R effect. Certain groups are also there which cannot show any type of resonance. Means they, suppose I have NH3 plus, so it will not pull electron towards it. Similarly, NR3, it will not pull. But if I have PR3 plus, then it can pull electron towards it because it has empty d orbitals, and in empty d orbitals it can accept electrons, so it will show minus R effect. Then species having empty d orbitals and empty p orbitals can show minus R effect. So this is very very basic things, but I want to tell you before solving questions. So we will take this question first. I want to compare stability of these four. So easy thing is, you have to first write down the what type of effects can be there. Okay, so it will not show any effect. Okay, it will show simple resonance effect. Then this fluorine can show, or halogens can show plus R effect, because they have three lone pairs of electron which can be donated, so they will show plus R effect, as well as they can show minus I effect. So it is applied for minus I effect will be at metaposition. Resonance effect cannot be at metaposition. It will be on ortho and para position, similar to hyperconjugation. In case of para, you will have again plus R and minus I effect. Now, in case of fluorine, plus R effect is much stronger than minus I effect. And other halogens like chlorine, bromine, iodine, minus I effect is much stronger than plus R effect. So this is also a one important thing you have to remember. Now, on the basis of these effects, we can decide stability of these carbocations. So plus R effect will provide stability to the system, and minus I effect will destabilize it. So I will first number them 1, 2, 3, and 4. So least stable will be when fluorine at metaposition, because it will show minus I effect and it will destabilize it. So third will be at least position. Okay, will be least stable. Then we will have this one, because there is no plus R effect. In these two and four, we have plus R effect. So one will be next. Then out of ortho and para, resonance effect will be more at para position as compared to ortho, and at ortho position, because it is close to this positive charge and inductive effect is governed by distances. Okay, so minus I effect will also take part. So two will be there, and most stable will be four, where maximum resonance effect. Then we will come to when we have ortho, para and meta substituted chlorines. So we have to memorize that chlorine, for chlorine, bromine and iodine, minus I effect is more as compared to plus R. Therefore, one will have maximum stability because there is no chlorine. And when we have chlorine at the maximum distance, then stability will be high because minus I effect is covered by distances. So 1, then will 4, then for 3, and least stability for 2, because it is close to CH2. We will not take here plus R effect, because minus I effect is much stronger. So this will be your stability order. Then we have these carbocations. So I will again number them. Now we will try to find out effects. So in this, hyperconjugation is present, plus H effect and plus I effect. In this one, we have plus H and plus I. In this one, because oxygen has two lone pair of electron and it can be donated, so it will show plus R effect and minus I effect, because oxygen has a higher electronegativity, so it can withdraw electrons towards it, so it also has minus I effect. Then chlorine has minus I effect. We will write minus I first, because plus R is very, very weak as compared to minus. Then for tertiary butyl, we have plus I effect, because it cannot show hyperconjugation. There is no alpha hydrogen present. Then we will take chlorine at meta position, so it will show only minus I effect. Then nitro at ortho position, so it will show minus R and minus I effect. So minus effects will destabilize this positive charge, because they are pulling electrons towards it. Okay, and next important thing is, you have to remember that resonance effect is much stronger than hyperconjugation effect, and hyperconjugation is much stronger than I effect. Okay, so you have to remember this thing also. So first we will try to find out which have plus effects, because they will more stabilize the system. So we know that plus R effect will more stabilize the system as compared to plus H effect, because resonance effect is much stronger than H and I effect. So 3 will have highest stability. Then out of 1 and 2, hyperconjugation is much higher in CH3 than CD3. We have seen it in previous part, that because of CD bond is much stronger as compared to CH bond, therefore next stability for 1, then for 2. This is all about plus effects. Okay, one more plus effect is for 5, fifth one. It will show plus R effect. So next stability will be for this one. 3, 1, 2, 5. Next we will come to minus effects, because minus effects will destabilize the system. Therefore, first we will take these two, because there is no minus R effect. Minus R effect will be more stronger than minus I effect. This is exception for Cl, but most of the time our resonance is more stronger than I. So next stability will be for fourth, because in sixth chlorine is close to plus charge. Okay, so next will be for fourth, then we will have sixth, and least stable will be seventh, where we have resonance as well as minus I effect. So next we will move to one more question. These are again the carbocations, and we have to decide their stability. So first I will number them. Okay, then we will decide what are the effects present. So this nitrogen having lone pair of electron, so it can show plus R effect. Okay, and it can also show minus I effect. Then in this case, we have oxygen present here. It can show plus R effect and minus I effect. Then CN will show minus R effect and minus I effect. Then this group, nitrogen having lone pair of electron, it can show plus R effect and minus I effect. In CD3, we have only plus I effect, because hyperconjugation cannot be present at meta position. Then in this case, we have plus H effect and plus I effect. Again in this one, we have plus H effect and plus I effect. And in case of chlorine, we will take only minus I effect. Resonance is also there, but we know that it is more stronger. So we will take only inductive effect. So first we will take plus effects, because they will stabilize carbocation, and resonance, whenever we have a resonance effect, it will stabilize more to the system. So plus R effect is present in 1, 2 and 4. So we have to decide which plus R effect will be more stronger. So in this case, we have an R2 group. I will take it separately, and OCOC. CH3 and NHCOCH3. Now you can easily find out which will show higher plus R effect. In this case, there is no other pulling effect from the R towards these electrons. Sorry, here we have only one lone pair of electrons. So there is only electrons are pulled by benzene ring, this ring. Okay. In this case, these two lone pair of electrons are pulled by this ring as well as this group also. It is also pulling because oxygen has higher electronegativity. So it will pull this pi electron towards it. This will also move here. And similarly, in this case, these lone pair of electrons will be pulled by this ring as well as by this group. Okay, so these lone pair of electrons in these two cases, they are not easily available for resonance because they are also pulled by this CH3CO groups. But in this case, this lone pair of electron is easily available to be donated. So highest plus R effect will be shown by 1. So it will show highest stability. Then out of 3 and 4, we have to decide out of 2 and 4. Not 3 and 4, 2 and 4. We have to decide on the basis of electronegativity of this atom attached. Out of nitrogen and oxygen, nitrogen has less electronegative atom. Therefore, it can easily give its electron. While oxygen has higher electronegativity, so it will not want to give its electron. So resonance effect will be stronger for fourth than for second. So this is all about plus R effect. We know that plus R effect is much stronger. Then we will come to the cations in which we have hyperconjugation effect. So hyperconjugation is present in 6th and 7th, but much stronger hyperconjugation will be for 7th, okay, because it has plus I effect also and it is close to positive charge. So next stability will be for 7th, then for 6th. So this is all about plus R and plus H effect. Then we will come to plus I effect. So plus I effect is only present in 5th one. So next stability for this one. Then we will come to minus effects. Minus effect means it has minus R as well as minus I. It has only minus I effect. So next stability will be for 8th. Okay, in case of minus effects, we will take which is less effective because resonance effect minus R will be more effective. It will pull electrons towards it and destabilize it at maximum. So least stability will be for third. So this will be your correct order. Next, we will take one more example. Then we will try to find out effects. Okay, so this nitrogen is positive charge and attached with 3 groups. Okay, so it does not have any lone pair of electron available, so it cannot show plus R effect. It will only show minus I effect. Okay, in this case we have plus R as well as minus I effect because its lone pair of electrons are available, so it will show plus R and minus I effect. And chlorine at para position will show minus I effect. It will also show minus R, but we will not take that. OH will show plus R and minus I. Then for PME3, we have minus R and minus I because it has positive charge but its d orbital is empty. It can accept electrons. Therefore, it will show minus R effect. Then we have CH3, which will show plus H effect and plus I effect. CD3 will also show plus H and plus I effect. Now we will take minus group first because minus group will take charge, negative charge from this carbon ion and stabilize it. It is already electron rich. So plus effects will cause addition of more electron and which will destabilize the system. So first we will take minus effects, and out of minus effect, which will be more stronger? Resonance effect is taken first because it will pull electron more effectively towards it. So fifth will have highest stability because only minus R effect is present in this one. Then we will take hyperconjugation effect, but there is no minus H effect is present. So we will take minus I effect. Minus I effect is present in 1 and 2. And out of 1 and 2, more stable will be 1 because it has positive charge. So it will be if more effectively pull electron. Then we will take third one. Next is 4 plus effects. Okay, and out of plus effect, we will take these two first because resonance effect will give electron more easily and more destabilize it. And out of 6 and 7, we will take in which hyperconjugation is less. So hyperconjugation will be less in 7th, so it will be more stable because it will not give electron easily and will not cause its destabilization as much causes by 6th. So next will be 4, 6th, and least stable will be 2nd. Okay, we will have one more. We have this one also. Plus R effect will be higher for second one because it is less electronegative. So next stability will be for fourth, and 2 will be least stable because it has highest R effect. It can cause highest destabilization of this carbon ion. So this is all about resonance, and this is very easy topic, but you have to remember certain things, that R effect is much stronger than H and then I, and you have to decide what effects are present in a particular group, and you have to decide which effect will be more pronounced, and on the basis of that you can decide stability. So I hope this topic is clear to you. I am taking these topics because they are concept built. So we will take some more lessons on this on different topics. So thank you so much for watching. If you like my videos, please hit the like button and share my videos with your friends, and please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much for watching.